Hi, I'm Elizabeth Newman. I am first and foremost a follower of Jesus Christ. I'm a wife and a proud mom. I voted for Trump in 2016 primarily because of the pro-life issue. I served in the Trump administration at the Department of Homeland Security and became the Assistant Secretary for Counterterrorism and Threat Prevention. In my role as Assistant Secretary for Counterterrorism, we looked at emerging threats, including the growing threat from domestic terrorists. And over the period of 2017 to 2018, we started to see that rise of the white supremacist agenda. I and my leadership at the Department of Homeland Security were very clear that we found the ideology behind white nationalism, white supremacy, to be a growing threat. A very common refrain that I was asked was, does the president's rhetoric make your job harder? And the answer is yes. The president's actions and his language are in fact racist. Things like, they're good people on both sides, or send them back from where they came from. Those words gave permission to white supremacists to think that what they were doing was permissible. And I do think that the president's divisive language is indirectly tied to some of the attacks that we have seen in the last 2 years. The reason government is supposed to exist is to plan and prepare for external threats like we're seeing today with COVID. There were plans put in place for a pandemic for 15 years. When we started to see that a pandemic was on its way to our shores in January, any number of experts told me we need to be executing on these plans. But from January until March 11th, what you saw instead was a number of good public servants attempting to do their job and the president telling them to stop because he didn't want the economy to tank and he didn't want a distraction from his campaign. I'm sorry, Mr. President. You were hired to handle America's worst day and you've absolutely failed. I do not think that we can afford 4 more years of President Trump. We are less safe today because of his leadership. We will continue to be less safe as long as he is in control. And this year I'll be voting for Joe Biden.